Good morning everybody. In this video, we will see how MNCs interlink production in different countries. Now children, any MNC, when it wants to set up its production unit, it will see some factors of production, like the markets should be easily available, then they should get skilled and unskilled labors at low cost. Then they will also look whether the government will look after their interest or not. And similarly, many other factors also MNCs will look to set up their production. And once all these conditions are fulfilled, then they set up their factories and offices. Now, when they set up their factories and offices, they have to buy land. So, the investment made or the money spent to buy the land, to buy the buildings, machines, equipments, everything is called as investment. So the money spent to buy all these things are called as investment. And when this investment is made by any multinational company, it is called as foreign investment. Now once foreign investment is done, that means production stops. Now there are three ways in which the multinational companies set up their production in various countries. So let us study about those three methods. First, any multinational company can jointly set up their production unit with any of the local companies. So when they join with some local company, or when an MNC collaborate with a local company, the local company is benefited more, because the local company will get new machines, and the MNC will give them new machines so that the production can be done in an easy manner and can be done fast. So new machines are supplied, then new equipments, latest technology will be brought by the MNCs, and that will also benefit the local companies. In this way, the production will increase. So jointly, it is jointly done with the local companies, and the local companies have twofold benefit. And one is MNC provides money for buying the new machines, and then MNC will bring the latest technology. In this way, collaboratively or jointly, MNCs and the local companies work. The second way in which MNCs set up their production is they buy the local companies. MNCs with lot of wealth can easily do it. Some MNCs have so much wealth that it is more than the budget of a government of a developing country. So there are such large MNCs. So with so much money, we can assume how much power and influence they are having. So such MNCs can buy any local company. And this is one of the common rule that MNC invests by buying up the local company, and then by buying the local company, they can expand their production. So one example we can give, there is an American multinational company which is called as Cargill Food. So this Cargill Food came to India, and in India there was a local company whose name was Parag Foods. So this Cargill company bought the Parag Foods, and by buying the Parag Food, they got advantage that this Parag Food was having a large marketing network, and they had a good reputation in the market. So when it was replaced by Cargill Food, Cargill Food can also sell their products easily in the market where the Parag Food used to sell their products. Then this Parag Food was also having 4 oil refineries, so that was also taken up by Cargill Food, and now the whole refinery work was shifted to Cargill Food. And now Cargill Food is the largest producer of the edible oil, and it produces 5 million pouches daily of edible oil. So this is the advantage of MNCs, that they buy the local companies. So they can get easy market. Now the third way in which MNCs set up their production is that large MNCs place orders for production with small producers. For example, if there is a sports equipment manufacturing MNC, suppose a football has to be manufactured. So the work of manufacturing football is given to some small producers, and especially in India, in Ludhiana, this work is done by women. So football making is done in Ludhiana by women, and when such things like garments, sports equipments, or footwear, these things are given to small producers, and then they produce it and they sell it and they give it to MNC. Then MNC will put a tag of their own country and then they will sell it at a very high price. So in this way, large MNCs place orders for production with small producers, and especially the things like garments, footwear, sports items, these are produced by the small producers. Even the jeans which are sold in USA and in other countries, they are locally manufactured, but the name tag and all becomes of MNC, and then it is sold at a very high cost. So the products are supplied after the production, like football or the jeans or these things, after producing, it is then given to supply to MNCs, and then MNC will sell it with their own brand names. And these MNCs have to decide, they have the power to decide the price of the product, the quality of the product, and the delivery and labor charges, labor conditions, everything is decided by the MNCs, and these local producers has to work according to the needs of the MNCs. So in this way, we can see that the production process can be widely dispersed, and this can be done in various locations, and this, in this way, it is though it is widely dispersed, but it is getting interlinked. So these are the three ways: one, joining of MNC with some local company, buying of a local company, or giving the orders for production to the local company or some small producers. In this way, production is interlinked, or production is done in various countries, but